Hello and welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, I'm going to cover a couple of the services that fall under the AWS Directory Services products. So that is the AWS Managed Microsoft AD, as well as the AD Connector. So let's get started. I'm starting off with the AWS Managed Microsoft Active Directory. This is a managed implementation of Microsoft Active Directory and it runs on Windows Server 2012. So you have an AWS account. In that account, you have your VPC, and in that you have some subnets. Now what happens when you create a managed Microsoft AD is it actually creates a high availability pair of Windows Server 2012 domain controllers across multiple subnets in multiple availability zones. That's how it's highly available. You can then use these Active Directory domain controllers for adding users and computers and using it for authorization. We'll see about some of the ways you can use it in a moment. Another thing you can do is if you do already have a Microsoft Active Directory running in your own company on premises or somewhere else, then you can connect that over a VPN and then you can create a trust relationship between the managed Microsoft AD and your own corporate self-managed Active Directory. So that can be a one-way or a two-way trust relationship. And a trust relationship is a concept associated with Microsoft Active Directory. And it basically means that there's a trust between these two directories so that users in one directory are able to authenticate and get authorized to access resources that are in another Active Directory. If you have a two-way trust relationship, it basically just means that you have that trust going both directions. So identities in either directory service are able to authenticate and get authorized to certain resources in the other Active Directory. When we launch our EC2 instances, and whether those are Windows or Linux, we can securely connect those to our managed Microsoft Active Directory. So for example, and we'll see this in the hands-on, you're able to join a Windows server or a Windows desktop, for instance, that might be running in Amazon workspaces. You're able to join those to the domain. And then that means that if you have a domain account, you can log on to those computers with a domain account. You can also connect to Azure Active Directory and also to Office 365. And you need a couple of services to do this called AD Sync and ADFS. And those will connect to the directory and mean that you can then synchronize users and federate identities with Azure and Office 365. So AD Sync is about synchronization and ADFS is a federation service. So it's a service which provides that federation, the identity provider service between your identity source, your AWS managed Microsoft AD, and then Azure AD or Office 365. There are also quite a few applications and services from AWS that support authentication and authorization using the AWS Managed Microsoft AD. So here's a few on the screen. And in the hands-on, we'll see how we can use Amazon Workspaces to authenticate and authorize to the Managed Microsoft AD and then access the AWS Management Console. AWS Managed Microsoft AD also supports group policies. So you can apply group policies and you have the ability to edit and apply those yourself. You can use single sign-on to many apps and services, as we've seen here. And you can also enable multi-factor authentication using Radius. The next service I want to cover is AD Connector. So in this example, let's say you've got a self-managed Active Directory. So you've got a Microsoft Active Directory running in your corporate office or in your data center, and it's one that you manage inside your company. And this is where your identities are stored, and you want to continue using this. You want to have one place where all your user accounts are stored, and those user accounts must then be able to access services in AWS. So what we can do is, again, we need to set up a VPN or a direct connect connection. And then we have the AD Connector service in AWS. And we connect our Active Directory to the AD Connector service. And then we can authenticate and get authorized to many different services in AWS. So for example, Amazon Workspaces. And a couple of other examples are WorkDocs and WorkMail. And you can also get access to the AWS Management Console. So this is a federated sign-in where you're mapping your Active Directory identities to IAM roles. And then your users, your Active Directory users from your corporate identity store are then able to access services using that role and whatever permissions that role has assigned to it. You can also seamlessly join Windows EC2 instances to your on-premise Active Directory domain via AD connector. So you've got an EC2 Windows instance running on AWS. You're able to, using the AD connector, actually join that EC2 instance to your Active Directory domain that's on-premises. So that's all I need to cover for now. And we're going to get on with some hands-on in the next couple of lessons. So I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you in the next lesson.